Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we are going to start with the geography lesson number 3, our changing earth. Movement of the earth is divided on the basis of the force which causes them. Now the earth movements are divided into two, endogenic forces and exogenic forces. Now endo means inside and exo means outside, and genic means origin. So endo means inside, genic means origin, means the forces which took place from the inside of the earth are called endogenic forces. The forces which act in the interior of the earth are called endogenic forces. Now exo means outside. The forces which origin on the outer layer of the earth are called exogenic forces. The forces that work on the surface of the earth are called exogenic forces. Means children, I hope you have understood about the endogenic and the exogenic. What will be the examples of the endogenic forces? The formation. These endogenic forces are responsible for the creation of the mountain, plateaus, plains, and rising and the sinking of the coastal plains. And these exogenic forces bring the visible changes on the earth surface, that is river, valleys, winds, etc. So these are the examples of endogenic and exogenic forces. Now in endogenic forces we see the sudden forces and the dystrophic forces. Now sudden forces means what? The changes which took suddenly on the earth's surface. For example, volcano, earthquakes. Landslides. These are the changes, this we can say the destruction also sometime. These are the changes which took place on the earth's surface suddenly, means they are not planned. But dystrophic forces means building mountains, etc. Means the mountains are not the procedure of one day. It takes so many years to form the mountains. So the endogenic forces are responsible for the sudden forces also and the dystrophic forces also. Similarly, in exogenic forces also we see the erosional and the depositional. Now these are the forces which create the changes on the earth's surface. Now erosional and depositional. Now during the rainy season we can see the soil eroding, erosion of the soil we see. Now the soil erodes and it deposits at the some place. These exogenic forces are responsible for the erosional and the depositional. Here we can take the example of rivers, valleys, seas, or we can also say river, valleys, sea waves, and also the glaciers. Now children, you have studied about the glacier. It is the huge ball of ice which comes through the valleys and it settles down, and from there the river starts or the river originates. For example, Ganga originates from the Gangotri glacier. So glacier, it erodes and it deposits at some place, and then from there the rivers, so the from where the river starts flowing. So these are the two forces responsible for the earth movement. The movements takes place because of the two forces, endogenic forces and exogenic forces. So how these two forces are responsible for the changes on the earth surface? In short, we can say that because of these internal and external forces we see the changes on the earth surface. So this is the first topic which I have have completed today, that is the lithospheric plates and the earth movement. Now read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. For today, this much is enough. Thank you.